Welcome to Vision Academy. This is the third lecture in the series of assignment problem lecture, and in this lecture I will address assignment problem under Hungarian method. So in the second lecture I have addressed four steps in Hungarian method, and in this lecture I will address all the steps from the Hungarian method. This is a minimization type of problem. This is the problem we have today to solve. So, to sum up this problem, a company producing a single product and selling it through five agencies situated in different cities. Suddenly, there is a demand of the five different product, five more cities for the product, and do not have agency in that cities. Now, the company faced with the problem of deciding how to assign the existing agencies to dispatch the product to the additional cities in such a way that the total distance is minimized. So the company is thinking to minimize the total distance taken by the traveling distance to minimize this. So for which the distance is given here to surplus cities to the deficit city, for which what we want to do is we want to determine the optimum assignment solution. So for this, let us calculate the assignment problem. These are steps which we need to follow in the Hungarian method, which I have already addressed four steps in the earlier lecture, second lecture. So now I will brief it. Firstly, we will check out the square matrix, that means whether it is a balanced one or unbalanced one, and then we will make a row reduction. Row reduction means identify the minimum cost in the row, minimum value in the row, and subtract all other value from that minimum value. First row in the row minimum, and subtract all other value from that minimum in that row. The same thing you will do in column reduction, but it should be done for the resulting matrix that you obtained in step 2. So here also you will go through column. In the column we will select minimum. After selecting minimum, you will subtract all other values from that minimum. So in the resulting matrix, you can obtain an optimum assignment. So to obtain optimum assignment, starting with row, examine until exactly 10 found, and you should start with row, and you should start with row, and you should identify there is only one row in each row. For that row, for that zero, draw a rectangle around that zero and trace out all other zeros in the corresponding column. So the relating the zero, the corresponding column must be striken out. The only zeros must be striken out. So you have to repeat the step one for all columns and rows. So firstly, you need to go for row, identify the only one zero, and give a rectangle around it and cross out all other zeros. And also you can go through column, you can identify only one zero and strike out the all other zeros corresponding to that row. When you start from row, you have to cross out in the column. When you start from column, you have to cross out in the row. Now let's do it. Then let us check the squared matrix. It means whether it is balanced or unbalanced. So we have two category. One is surplus city, one more is deficit city. In the surplus city, we have five surplus city. Also we have five deficit city. It means number of rows are five, number of columns are five. So which means this is a squared matrix, which means a balanced assignment problem. So then let's start with the row reduction. So before you make a row reduction, you should identify the row minimum first. Let's go with row. So look at here. So 160, 130, 175, 190, 200. Then 130 is a minimum. So 130 is minimum here. And in the second column, look at here. So 120 is a minimum. And in the third column, 110 is a minimum among all other values in the row. And in the fourth row, 50 is a minimum. We have 250, so we can arbitrarily select any 150. So in the fourth row, 35 is a minimum. So by this way, we identify the minimum in each row. So now, so that is a row. We started from row and we have identified the minimum value in each row. And now we have to subtract the all other values from this minimum value. It means, so here it is 160. If you subtract from 130, the next value will be 30. And here 130 minus 130, 0. And here 175 minus 130, it is 45. And here 190 minus 130, it is 60. And here 200 minus 130, it is 70. So by this way, we obtained the row reduction value. So for each rows, we have respected minimum value. From that respected minimum value, we have to subtract all other values in the column. And I will show you another example. I will let's calculate to this E row. So here 35 is a minimum. 55 minus 35, this is 20. And 35 minus 35, this is 0. And 70 minus 35, this is 35. And 80 minus 35, which is 45. And 105 minus 35, which is 70. So let us look at this C if you want to cross it out. So 110 is a minimum. 140 minus 110, which is 30. And 110, which is 0. So, and 155 minus 110, 45. And 170 minus 110, which is 60. And 185 minus 110, which is 75. By this way, we got this resulting matrix from step 2. So we identify the row minimum first. We started with row, that is R, and in the row we identify the minimum value in each row, and from that minimum value we subtracted all other value. So by doing this performance, we got that resulting matrix, okay, from step 2. So now we have to make a column reduction. For column reduction, we have to take the output of second step. Okay, I have taken the second step here. So now it is time to make a column reduction. In the column reduction also, you have to go through columns, column wise, and in the column identify the minimum value. Let's identify the minimum value. Look at here it is 0. 0 is minimum, which is this column, and here all are 0, so you can take any 0. So here 10, 10 is minimum value, and here 30 is a minimum value, 30 is a minimum value, and here 55 is a minimum value, 55 is a minimum value. So we identify minimum value. Now what we want to do is, we want to subtract all other value from that minimum value, which means 0. And one thing you should keep in your mind, when you have column minimum or row minimum as 0, you don't have to subtract from all other values, because anything subtracted by 0 would be same. Example, 30 minus 0, which will be 0 only, 30 only. 50 minus 0, 15, and like that. Here it is also 0. You don't need to subtract that. You can take the values as it is. Look at here, the same value in this step. We got that. So 30 minus 0 is 0, and 0, 0, 0, 0. And here, look at here, 10 is minimum. So 45 minus 10, which is 35. And 10 minus 10, 0. And 45 minus 10, 35. And 30 minus 10, 20. And 35 minus 10, which is 25. So in the same way, let's make a row reduction, a column reduction. So the minimum is here 55, and the first value is 70. 70 minus 55, which is 15, 70, 55 minus 55, which is 0, and 75 minus 55, which is 20, and now 60 minus 55, which is 5, and 70 minus 55, which is 15. So this is the resulting matrix of step 3, that is column reduction. So again, I will tell you, we identify the we gone through column first, and in the column we identify the minimum row minimum. Here it is a row minimum, and from that row minimum, column minimum, and from that column minimum we subtract all other values, and after doing so we got this thing. So same result output will be carried for next step. So this is the output we obtained by this. And here the first step, you need to come to step 4. In the step 4, we are fulfilling one step 4 sub step is 4.1. So here I said to you, you should start with 0, row, that's row. From in the row, find the find the single zero and give a rectangle around that single zero, and cross out all other zeros in the column. So row, rectangle, single zero, cross out other zeros in column. Cross out other zeros in the column. That is a decoding of RSS OCOC, and let's perform this by row. First, I will go to A row. So here we have single zero in this row. Yes, exactly, single zero in this row. And after the identifying single zero, give a rectangle around it. I have given a rectangle around it, and which is a single zero in this row. So later you should cross out other zeros in the column, only zeros, not any values. And here all other zero values are zero. So I will cross out all other values, all other zeros, not any value. I am crossing out only zeros. Okay. Now I will come to second row. So B row. So I look at here. Yes, it is 1020. We cannot do this for this row because we have two zeros here. And coming to third row, look at here. We don't have any zeros. We had 10, which is striken out. Okay. And coming to fourth, that is D surplus city, that is row, we have 10 and we have one more zero, and other zero is striken out, so left zeros are 2. So last row, there are no rows here. So this is over, that starting with row, identify the zero which is single in that row and give a rectangle around that, and cross out all other zeros in the column. So now we have to proceed for further step. So let us move to the next step, which is in the fourth step, second step, which is, and it is a result of the step 4.1. And here in the 4.2 step, we should start from column, and we should identify the single zero in that column and give a rectangle around it, and cross out all other zeros which are in row. So column, row, rectangle, single zero, cross out other zeros in row. So let's so in the first row, so one single zero is here, single zero, there is no more than one zero, and I have identified the single zero in this column, and I'm going to cross out all other zeros which are existing in that row. So I started with column, I'm striking in row, and I will come to the second column. In the second column, one assignment is there and other zeros are striken out. And in the third column, look into the third column, we have 10 here. So again, we can make an assignment, and we have to cross out all other zeros in that row. this 0 is already striken out, no need to strike again. So coming to fourth column, there are no 0, one 0 is here because, and which is striken out. And coming to fifth row, fifth column, one 0 is here which is striken out. So 4.2 step is over by doing this. So what we did is we gone through column this like this, and we identify the single 0 in that column and given a rectangle around that 0 and crossed out all other zeros in the row. Okay, this is fine. And in the 4.3 step, we have to select alternatively any 0 and cross out all other zeros by making a optimum assignment. So arbitrarily select 0 and cross out all other 0. I will go through column row. So here there are no zeros to select. So here there are no zeros to select, and here there are no zeros to select again. Here also there are no zeros to select. There are zeros which is not striken out and assigned. So there are no zeros in this matrix which are not assigned, or either which are not assigned, or either which are not crossed out. So we have to check the optimality condition. So if you here we want to check the optimality condition. To check optimality condition, we should ensure that in each and every column and row we have one assignment. Let us look into the step for that. So we have completed step 4.3. This is 4.3, and let us look into the 4.4. So which is if each row and each column of the resulting matrix has one and only assigned 0, that is given a rectangle 0, that must be one and only in each column and row. The optimum assignment is made in the cells to 0. So if there is only one 0, one assigned 0 in each row and column, then it is an optimum solution. So otherwise, go to next step. We have to check the optimality condition here. Otherwise, if the optimality condition is not reached here, we have to move for step 5. Let us look into the optimality condition in that step 4.4. Look at here. Let us go through column row wise. We have one 0 here. So one 0 is assigned to this row. And in the second row is also one 0, one rectangle 0. And in the third row, there are no assignment. There is no rectangle 0. So there is no assignment. And in the fourth row, yes, there is one 0 which is given rectangle. And in the fifth row, there is no 0 which has rectangle. Let's go by column wise. Yes, we have one assignment. Yes, we have one assignment. Here too, we have one assignment. But in the fourth and fifth column, we have no assignment, which means this is not a optimal condition, optimal solution. In the assignment problem, one person must handle one task, which means A, according to this solution, A has to handle this second deficit city, and B is third deficit city, and C has no assignment here, and D has assignment that first deficit city, and E has no assignment here, which means this is not a optimal solution, which means we have to move further for fifth step. Next step is this fifth step. Fourth step number 4, step number 5, and step number 5-6 are very important in Hungarian method. Let us look into the step number 5, what it says. So look at here, draw the minimum number of horizontal and vertical lines through all the zeros. Okay, so for step number 5 is to draw a minimum number of horizontal and vertical axes. Okay, to draw that, we have to follow this. We have to follow this guidelines. Actually, Hungarian method, the steps are very logical. So you have to go through the logical to make an optimum solution. He has formulated in the logical way. Okay. So first one, tick the right mark in the rows in which assignment has not made. Very, very precisely, I will go with step one step so that you can understand it. So let's fulfill the step number 5.1 then. For the step 5, I have taken the output of step 4.4. Up to step 4.4, we have performed this thing. And for step 5, I have taken the output of the resulting matrix in 4.4. So first step in this is, in the 5.1 step is, tick the right mark in the rows in which assignment has not made. Let us look into the rows. So we have one assignment here. We can't give a right mark. And in the B, we have one assignment. We can't give a right mark. And in the C, yes, there is no assignment. Tick a right mark. Okay, in the D row, we have assignment. So we don't have to tick a right mark. In the E, yes, there is no assignment. Tick right mark. We fulfilled step number 5.1. So let us look at the step number 5.2. Tick mark columns which have zeros in the marked row. So we must be very careful. Tick mark the columns, tick the right mark in the columns which have zeros in the marked row. Let's go and see that. Look at here, the step number 5.2 is tick mark columns which have zeros in the marked row. So look at here, we have tick marked this. In this row, we have tick marked. So tick mark columns which has zeros in the marked row, which means we have ticked this row. Okay, let us see whether it is there is zero or not. Look at here, there are no zeros here. And also in the second column, we have ticked this row. So and there is zeros, which means we have to tick out here. Okay, what is that step 5.2 says? Tick right mark the columns which have zeros in the marked row. So which have zeros in the marked row only in the, let us look into the other marked thing. So we have a marked row here, but here there are no zeros here, so we cannot tick this. And here there are no marked rows. We have only 3 marked rows in which only this column has zeros. So that is why I have marked for this only. So now then we have completed step number 5.2 also. Let us look into the step number 5.3, which says tick mark rows not already marked which have assignments in marked columns. Recently we marked a column, no? In that we have to tick right mark in the rows which have assignments in marked columns. Let us look at here, and then tick mark columns which have zeros in newly marked rows. So it will apply only if you tick mark the rows which has assignment in marked columns. Let us look at. So step number 5.3 is tick mark rows which have assignment in marked columns. Yeah, so here only one marked column is this. So let us look at the marked columns. So now we have to tick mark rows which have assignments in marked column. So look at here. Is there any assignment here? Yes, here in this column, in this ticked column, we have assignment. Then tick mark this. Tick mark this, and there are no assignment. So we have striken out all other zeros and there are no assignment. We have only one row which has assignment in tick marked column. And after this, we have to tick right mark in the columns which have zeros in the newly marked row. So you look at this newly marked row. If there are any zeros, so we have to tick. There are no zeros, we don't have to tick here. So if not, we don't have to perform this. So there are no zeros here, we don't have to perform this. So by this we have completed step number 5.3 also. Let us look into the other steps. So step number 5.4 is draw straight line through all unmarked rows and marked columns. This is very important. Unmarked rows and marked columns. We have to draw a straight line through unmarked rows and marked columns. Look at this matrix. We have to draw a line in the unmarked rows and marked columns. So I will draw here because this is unmarked row. Here it is marked. Here first, third and fifth rows are marked, and second and third rows are unmarked. So for that I will draw a line which is unmarked in the rows, and draw a line in which the marked column, the marked column is this only, other are not marked column. So for this I will draw a line, so by this we also completed step number 5.4. So friends, step number 5 is very very important. If you are not able to have a optimal solution in step number 4, you have to proceed for step number 5. So by this we obtained that resulting matrix. Now let us go to the step number 6. So this is step 6. In the step 6 we have to revise the cost matrix. So we have to revise the cost matrix in step number 6. So in the step number 6, how to revise cost matrix, the guidelines are given. So step number 6.1 is this: find the smallest element not covered by any of the lines. We should find out the smallest element not covered by any of the lines that drawn in the step number 5.4. Then look at the cost matrix this. So look at here, we have to find out the smallest element. In the first row, smallest element is 15, and there is a condition that smallest element must not be covered by any rows, any lines. So we should select the smallest element except the lines covered by the values. Okay, here 15 and here 20. 15 is lesser than the 20, and here it is covered by lines, and here again 15 15. So it means 15 is the smallest element. So 6.1 step is over. Then look at the step number 6.2. subtract this from all the uncovered elements. So this is very, very important. You found out the smallest element. So in the cost matrix, except the lines covered by in any of the rows or column. So after this, subtract this from 15. You need to subtract from all the other uncovered elements. Uncovered elements means which is not covered by lines. And we have to subtract from uncovered element, and we have to add. We have to add it to the elements at the intersection. So in the intersection we have to add, and in the other uncovered element we have to subtract. So intersection means the intersection of two lines, where two lines get together. This is an intersection. The case in which you are finding the intersection in the cost matrix, you have to add there. And in another uncovered elements, you have to subtract. And just look at the step number 6.3. other elements covered by lines remain unchanged. This is very important. Only in the intersection you will make change, only in the uncovered element you will make change, and other elements covered by the lines remain unchanged. So how to do is, look at here, this is uncovered area and this is uncovered area. These are uncovered area, okay, and this is intersection. Look at this, this is one intersection and This is second intersection. We have two intersection in this cast matrix. In the intersection, you should add the minimum element, that is 15. And in the uncovered areas, you have to subtract. And other lines, covered by lines, remain unchanged. This is very important. There are three things important in the step number 6. One, you should subtract at uncovered area. Example 30, 35, 30, 15, these are uncovered area, and you should add in the intersection, and other things will remain change, it means remain constant where the lines are drawn. So which means if you subtract 30 minus 50, it will be 15, and here there is no change here because it is covered by line. Here 35 minus 15, 20, and here 30 minus 15, 15, and 15 minus 15, 16, and 0, it should not be changed because it is covered by line. 35 minus 15, it is 20, and 30 minus 15, it is 15, 15 minus 15, it is 0. And coming to second row, so it is, you should not touch this row, it should remain same because it is covered by line. So it means 15 0 0 0 15 0 0 10 0 15 0, but here it is not 0 because it is intersection. In the intersection we should add 15. So look at here, I have marked a right mark because it is intersection. Here two intersection, so in the intersection you should add, in the uncovered area you should subtract. So subtract, here we don't have to subtract because it is covered by line and there is intersection. In the intersection I have added 15. So it means 15, 15, 0, 10, 0. 15, 15, 0, 10, 0. Okay. Next third row, it should be subtracted by 15 because it is uncovered area. 15 minus 15, 15. And it should not be touched, remain same because the covered by line. So same. And here 35 minus 15, it is 20, and 30 minus 15, 15, and here 20 minus 15, it is 5. Coming to fourth row, it should not be touched because it is covered by line, it should remain same, but here it is an intersection. In the intersection we should add 15, the minimum value, it means 0 plus 15, 15 in the intersection, and rest of the things will remain same. 0, 15, 20, 0, 5. 0, 15, 20, 0, 5. Okay. Coming to last row, it is uncovered area. 20 minus 15, which means 5, and it is there is a covered line, so it should remain same. So 0. So here it is 25. 25 minus 15, it is 10. Here it is 15, 15. So then it must be 0, 0. Okay. This is how you obtained by making a revised cost matrix in the step number 6.1, 2, 3. So after this, you should go with the step number 4. Because step number 1 is, let us look into the steps first. Look at the step number 7. Repeat the procedure until an optimal solution is attained. It means from the first step, you should go from the first step. Okay. You should repeat the steps until you obtain optimal solution after making these changes. So for steps means we have done it. Step number 1, we have done it and we don't have to do it again. And step number 2, row reduction, column reduction, it is not relating to any changes. Okay, so step number 4 onwards we have made changes. So now you have to proceed from step number 4 directly, not step number 1, 2, 3, because which is not at all related to the any changes. First of all, you need to check the square matrix and row maker reduction and make a column reduction, and then you will proceed to step number 4. Now after making changes in step number 6, you have to come back to the step number 4. Step number 4 says, starting with row, examine until exactly 1 0 found. Okay, give a rectangle around this 0 and cross out all other zeros corresponding to the column, and same procedure for all rows and the same thing for columns also. So now let's perform this to have an optimum solution. We will perform further resulting matrix obtained by step number 6. Okay, so starting with row, let us find the z single zero. So in this row we have two zeros, we cannot perform for this. In this row also we have two zeros. Yes, in the third row we have single zero, and we can this is a single zero, we can give a rectangle around it. We can cross out all other zeros corresponding to that column. So corresponding to this row is this column. So strike out all other zeros, only zeros, not any values. Okay, coming to fourth row, yes, 10 and 10, two zeros are there, we cannot do any performance here. So in the fifth row, so what we have, 10 20, we have 20, and step row process treatment is over. Now we have to make a column treatment. Okay, starting with column, find a single zero. Yes, we have single zero here, and strike out all other zeros corresponding to that row. So in the column we have found single zero, and strike out all other zero corresponding to the row, corresponding to that column. This is a row, I have striken out that. Okay, now then looking to the second row, there are no zeros, two zeros are crossed out, one zero is assigned, there is an assignment. And let us look into the third row, third column. In the third column we have 10, yes, and we have to cross out all other zero corresponding to that row. So cross out this, only 10 are there, and go to next column, that is column number 4, and we have 10, another zero is crossed out, we have 10, so we can give that treatment and cross out all other zero corresponding to that row. Okay, only 10 is here, and cross it out that, and go to last column, that's column 5. So we have only 10 here. Okay, we have 10. So after making this step number 4, we have to ensure that whether we have made a optimum allocation. To ensure that, we have to check in each and every row there is only one assignment. It means only one given rectangle zero. So look, let us check that. So I will go through row wise. Yes, in this row we have one assignment, that is A5. Yes, in B row we have one assignment, that is B3. And in C row we have one assignment, that is C2. And in the D row we have one assignment, that is D1. And in E row one assignment. We don't have two assignment, we have only one assignment in each row. Let's check it by column. Yes, in this row, in this column we have one assignment only, in this column two, one assignment only, in this column two, one assignment only, in this column two, one assignment, in this column two, one assignment, which means we have made a optimum allocation. This is a optimum allocation which you have done, and you cannot make a much more optimal allocation than this. So now we have reached it to optimum allocation, we can stop giving procedure, and let us look into the assignment, which means A2 5, B2 3, C2 2, D2 1, E2 4. Okay, look at this, A2 5, here A2 5, second one B3, B2 3, yes it is B2 3, and third one C2 2, yes this is C2 2, and in the fourth one D2 1, this is, and in the fifth one E2 4. So if you want to know the distance, these distance, you have to go to the basic problem. In the problem they have given some distance to surplus cities to deficit city. So by that we have taken this. Let us look into that. And this is a basic problem. We have made assignment to A to 5. This is it, which means surplus city A2, deficit city 5 will take 200 distance, 200 kilometer, and B2 3. So B2 3, which means surplus city B2, deficit city 3 will take 130 kilometer distance, and C2 2. So the same way D2 1, E2 4. So we have taken this the distance, total distance. By this way we will find the total distance by having surplus city A2 5, B2 3, C2 2, D2 1 and E2 4. Let us look into the total distance taken by these 5 surplus cities to these 5 deficit city. The total distance, if you add all these distance, it will be 570 kilometer to make a transshipment to surplus city to deficit city. So friends, we have made this very easy. So you will, if you are not yet subscribed to my Vision Academy YouTube channel, please do subscribe, share, like to my channel, and you will receive much more videos on operation research. Thank you so much.